I was bathing my older children and I had my son on the ground and I went to pick him up. And as I was picking him up, I felt this almost like a snap, like you would with an elastic band. And then I felt this intense pressure. And I actually thought that it was my stitches that had busted. When I had a moment, I went into the bathroom and got a hand mirror out and had a look, and I just saw this bulge. And I was so frightened. I waited for my husband to come home, and then the first thing we did was call the emergency room because I thought that something terrible was happening. We spoke to a midwife and she asked me a few questions around how many children I had. And when she found out how, you know, big my son was when born, she said, "Oh, well, that's to be expected. You've had a prolapse." And I was still in shock and in tears, and I'm like, "Oh, what is a prolapse?" I had no idea. She was so blasé and just said, "Well, best thing to do is contact your obstetrician and go see him at your 6-week checkup."
And Taya, when you mentioned you didn't know what a prolapse was, did you then go and try and figure out what this word was and what it meant for you and your body?
Yeah, so pretty much spent, I think, most of the night either, you know, feeding my son or researching it.
You then went to your obstetrician for the 6-week checkup. What did he say to you?
I almost went in expecting, you know, some sort of resolution or direction or anything like that. And again, the response was very much, "You've had 3 kids, 2 very large kids. And so, you know, again, it's a prolapse. This is what happens. This is, you know, birth." It's, again, expected, very blasé. I just bursted into tears and I just sort of said, "This isn't to be expected. I didn't expect it. I didn't know about it."
Did he say that this would have an effect on other parts of your life, that you couldn't do certain things again?
Yep. So not only couldn't I run, but things like he was telling me, I would be mindful of how heavy my shopping was packed. Don't wear high heels because the gravity, the weight. And I was just blown away by, you know, what the things that I couldn't do. It was life-changing for me at that point.